I will not sleep again.
Wait. I'm in the body now,
Pastor. For created it when a child. He will take good care of you. And he's so well. So can't you see her? He's so pretty, wonderful.
Is this sister Tommy that is calling again? Hey.
Hello, sister.
Hello, everybody.
How far now?
I'm fine. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon now.
Hi.
I'm fine.
Okay.
I'm good. What's the problem? I'm just ready to call
you. I want to see you. Can I come over?
Eh? Yes. Yeah.
To your house.
For what? I think it's almost time for you. Why are you?
And now, I can come.
You can't come. Excuse me. Please go for the Yaga. We'll see in the church. Anything you want to stop me, stop me during the service or after the service. Do you hear me? Then, bye. God bless you. Tell me the pastor. Hey, you get me, no?
there's somewhere there that says, you know that guy, he later thought and said, I will arise and go back to my father.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
I want deep meaning of that passage, deep meaning of that sentence.
That's what we are doing. The meaning of that verse said that we arise. But then there will be spoken word there and we arise. It means there is a determination. There is a consciousness of that you are coming from somewhere. There is a consciousness of the source in that brother, in that prodigal son, that makes him go back to his father. So when you are a sinner, for you to go back to God, you have to have the consciousness that He is your source. Before God can accept you, you have to dedicate yourself, you have to give your life to Christ and create every possession to this. Is that okay?
But I'm very good. Thank you, sir. That place is very good. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
God bless you.
God bless you.
God bless you, my son.
Thank you, sir.
Minister Dam, Minister Memo.
Hallelujah! Yeah. Today we are going to talk about a passage or a title says, I will arise and go back to my father. Yeah, I will arise and go back to my father. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah, you know, when we check the Bible very well, you look at the book of Luke chapter 15. Maybe you are still a sinner. God is calling you now to cogitate, to think, and to make up your mind to come back to Him, and He will surely forgive you. Can I hear you say amen?
Amen.
Can I hear you say amen?
Amen.
So we don't know. Maybe some of you are still a sinner. All you need to do is just lay down and think of yourself and make up your mind, search your mind, and say, I will arise and come back to my father. I realize and come back to my father. And this, as you make up your mind to go back to that your father, He will surely forgive you. Can I say amen?
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
Praise God, praise God, praise God. May God bless you. May the anointing that I receive from the Lord join me with my glad new body.
Yes, sir.
I declare that anointing. I join the anointing and I declare upon your life this moment that you will prosper.
Yeah.
And you will receive grace.
Yeah.
God bless you.
Yeah.
And everybody was shouting. I didn't understand. I cannot remember when last people were joyous when I was having some. Then he came here, knelt down beside me, and I'm the one that brought him up. You're free to me.
Hello.
For what? understand the game. One of them just returned the time they get see. What's his name, sir? I don't understand. This guy get out of my house. I will show them that touch. They will know I'm a leader.
Thank you.
Baba.
Don't come near me.
Baba, what happened?
What is this?
Baba, this is the altar you gave to me now.
I gave you a black altar.
Oh, Baba.
Look at the head with you again.
Baba, this thing is original.
Hey! where are you going to pass? Look at the soul given unto you. How is this stuff?
Baba, I'm sorry.
Look at your altar.
Baba, please. Give me another chance. Oh, Baba. Baba, please, I will not finish like this. Baba, you must finish well.
Thank you.